Good morning, Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen who joined the conference today. We all gathered here to celebrate the 30th anniversary of the reestablishment of diplomatic relations between the Republic of Poland and the State of Israel. The conference has been organized by the Polish Institute in Tel Aviv with the Embassy of the Republic of Poland in Israel and the Jagiellonian University in Krakow, in cooperation with several Polish and Israel institutions, such as Herzl Center Krakow, IMUNA, the Israeli Model United Nations Association, and the Polish Forum of Young Diplomats. Special words of appreciation for involvement in this event also go to the Embassy of Israel in Poland and the Chancellery of the Prime Minister of the Republic of Poland, Israel Council of Foreign Relations, Yad Vashem, the Museum of the History of Polish Jews, POLIN, the Association of Israeli Guides to Poland, Mashmaut Center, Spark Pro Organization, and Living Bridge Foundation. Dear guests, I have a great pleasure to welcome all the former diplomats from Poland and from Israel who have been part of making of the 30 years of mutual history. Thank you for your contribution and for being with us today. My name is Ewa Węgrzyn. I am PhD lecturer at the Jagiellonian University in Krakow in the Institute of Jewish Studies, and I will be your host for today's conference. The conference program is the following. After the official opening and welcoming remarks, you will be invited to participate in four panels. All panels are 1 hour long and focus on topics such as history and modern practice of bilateral diplomatic relations, education and remembrance, cultural diplomacy, as well as a workshop for Polish and Israeli young adepts of diplomacy. The first two panels will start with a short introductory lectures, followed by 15 minutes of questions and answers. Please kindly note that the questions must be written in the chat. The conference will be concluded by closing remarks. Last but not least, the whole conference is being recorded. Let's proceed to the welcoming and opening remarks by our distinguished speakers. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to invite His Excellency, Ambassador of the Republic of Poland to the State of Israel, Mr. Marek Magierowski.
Good morning, everyone. I'm genuinely thrilled to have this opportunity to address such a distinguished audience, scholars, ambassadors, journalists, artists, people of goodwill, who have worked so hard over the last three decades to foster our bilateral relations, to shed more light on our common history, so rich and so complex at the same time. People who have largely contributed to better understanding between our nations and societies. As an inexperienced and a poorly talented diplomat, I am boundlessly thankful that I can tap into your knowledge in order to follow suit in so many fields and in so many dimensions. A few moments ago, you saw a short clip with Ambassador Palzel in the lead role, presenting his credentials to President Jaruzelski as the first official representative of the State of Israel in Poland after the reestablishment of our relations. That very footage perfectly illustrates the convoluted nature of both nations' history. Israel had been free and independent since 1948, although constantly coping with an insecure geopolitical environment. Meanwhile, Poland suffered under the yoke of the Soviet Union, regained its freedom in 1989, yet it was General Jaruzelski, the very face of the brutal reprisals against the Polish anti-communist opposition, who at that time received Ambassador Palzer as head of state. We cannot airbrush the past, but luckily so many things have changed ever since, except Ambassador Palzer himself, who hasn't changed at all. So many good things happened between Poland and Israel in the meantime. So many cities and schools established ties with each other. Synagogues in Poland got refurbished. Jewish cemeteries restored, albeit not yet all of them. So many people realized how important Jewish legacy had always been as part of Polish culture and identity. On the other hand, so many Israelis have fallen in love with Poland. My sincere gratitude to LOT Airlines and El Al, which are not sponsors of this conference, so I can name them impunely. And this infatuation with Poland stems not only from the fact that for thousands of Israeli visitors, Poland is the homeland of their ancestors, but also a friendly country of thriving economy, picturesque landscapes, excellent food, and last but not least, shamelessly low prices. Let it remain this way. We cannot escape history. We should debate the thorniest issues, but always look on the bright side of life. On the final note, I want to express my heartfelt thanks to the organizers of this conference who have already been mentioned and to all participants. Thanks a lot for listening and have a fruitful discussion. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Your Excellency. And now it's my great honor to invite His Excellency, Ambassador of the State of Israel to the Republic of Poland, Mr. Aleksander Ben-Zvi.
Well, thank you very much, Eva, and it's a pleasure to be here. It's actually very moving to see this short video, as I had the chance to be here with Ambassador Peltur since the beginning, since the year 1986. I was his deputy. I unfortunately had no chance to see the presentation of the credentials. When I was here, we were still were Sekte Interes of Israela. The Israeli interest section was the Dutch embassy and later independent interest section, but unfortunately I had no privilege to be at the presentation of the credentials with the full diplomatic relations. I completely agree with Ambassador Magyarovsky that those relations in those 30 years went through a lot of changes with ups and downs, which we all remember. But, it's for me like a closure after 30 years to come back to Poland. It's not a big secret that I'm leaving Poland in a very short time to be ambassador in Moscow, but at least I had the chance to come and work here for the last year and so, and to meet most of you, all of you, and I hope to contribute in some way to development of our relations. I also agree with Ambassador Magyarovsky that we have to look in the future. And many of my interviews here, I said many times that we should not forget the past. We cannot forget the past. We have to work on it all the time. But we as diplomats, and I would say also the politicians, should not make the past our working program for the future. We have to leave all the research for those who really know about this. And I mean Yad Vashem or Tel Aviv University, Jerusalem University, Pilecki Institute, Warsaw University, Jagiellonian University. We have a lot of institutions to deal with those issues. And we, I would say, at least that's my vision of the future relations. We have to concentrate on the things that we have to work for the future. And we have several, I would say, dimensions. One is the international dimension. It's like our common interest in on the international arena, fighting terrorism, something like Warsaw conference that we had at the beginning of last year. We have the international organizations, we have the EU. So we have quite a lot of things together on the international arena, but also on the bilateral issues. We have our economic relations, we have our cultural relations, and we have tourism. As you probably know, last year we had, and Ambassador Magierowski mentioned it, we had last year 300,000 Israeli tourists in Poland and around 170,000 Polish tourists in Israel. So the numbers, you see, 500,000 people last year were traveling between our countries. So this is a very, very important issue, and we have a lot of work to do, and I'm sure that my successor will concentrate on that as well. I'm really pleased to see many of my friends on the screen. I mean, from my fellow town, Lea Ganor, from Kiryat Motzkin, or of course, Ambassador Tzvi Ravner, who we know for at least 36 years, 30-something years. We will not tell nobody. But we worked together many, many years. And of course, Ambassador Poltura, as I mentioned at the beginning, who was my first boss in the diplomatic service here in Poland. So this is, I would say, my remarks for the beginning. I'm sure we will have very interesting discussions, and I wish all of us a very good day and seminar. And well, I have to say that those 30 years passed quite fast. Thank you.
Thank you, Excellency. And now I would like to invite to the stage Mrs. Katarzyna Dzierżawska, the Acting Director of the Polish Institute in Tel Aviv.
Thank you. Your Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Before I begin, I would like to express my appreciation to all our friends who organized this conference together with us, especially to Dr. Ewa Węgrzyn and Dr. Tomasz Cybulski from Jagiellonian University, Julia Mackiewicz-Saban from Polish Institute, and Katarzyna Rybka-Iwańska from the Polish Embassy. This year, the Polish Institute in Tel Aviv celebrates its 20th birthday, but it looks back to a much longer tradition. Already in the late 50s, there was a special place on the map of Tel Aviv, which not only cherished the connection between Poland, but also secured the space for intellectual discussion, literary reviews, and cultural exchange. And of course, I'm talking about Neuenstein's bookstore, the place described by many as the first Polish cultural institute in Tel Aviv. Thanks to the renewal of the diplomatic relations, the Polish Institute could be established in the year 2000. Thus, joining the Neuenstein couple, as well as the Poland-Israel Friendship Association, the Piast Association, numerous associations of former residents of Polish regions and cities, and others, in promoting Polish culture in Israel. For the last 20 years, the Polish Institute has been active in the field of public diplomacy and cultural diplomacy, trying to reach out to the Israeli public with the best theater productions, most interesting books, engaging movies, inspiring visual arts, but also discussion about history and our shared past. Even now, during the COVID crisis, thanks to our Israeli partners who during these challenging times demonstrate enormous creativity, we continue to be present with Polish movies in your homes, visual art exhibition in open public spaces, online lectures, discussions, even virtual, but how very real live concerts. Actually, tomorrow you will be able to listen to very rarely performed, brilliant vocal works of Chopin on the radio. I just seized this opportunity to thank from the bottom of my heart all our Israeli counterparts for such a wonderful cooperation and partnership. And special thanks go to the entire crew of the Polish Institute for the wonderful performance. I would like to finish with just one more thought. Nowadays, we use all sorts of technology and platforms to communicate with each other, with our partners, with our audience, and whatever online or offline, Polish Institute is dedicated to our universal values, sincere discussions, and very personal encounters, and will continue serving as a platform for dialogue. It is of utmost importance to continue the chain of connections and to keep creating joint projects in this unique and meaningful Polish-Israeli context, and to approach each other with respect, trust, and understanding. That is why I am so pleased to especially welcome young participants, because I'm sure that you, the youngest generation, will secure this future of this significant relationship. Thank you.
Thank you, Director Dzierżawska, for your opening remarks. And now I would like to invite Professor Sławomir Sprawski, Vice Dean of the Faculty of History at the Jagiellonian University in Krakow.
Thank you. Your Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's my great pleasure and privilege to welcome you here today on behalf of Faculty of History of Jagiellonian University and also of the Institute of Jewish Studies. Polish-Israeli academic relations have already quite a long history. Everything started in 1986 when the Research Center on History and Culture of Jewish in Poland at the Jagiellonian University was established. The opening event was in an international conference held in September 1986. It was the first meeting of the scholars specializing in Jewish studies from Poland, France, Israel, the United States, and Great Britain after the war. Since then, there has been a vivid academic cooperation between Poland and Israel. At the Jagiellonian University, there are bilateral academic agreements with some Israeli universities, for example, with Hebrew University of Jerusalem. We organize a lot of conferences. There's a student exchange program and also joint research programs. Within Jagiellonian University, there is the Institute of Middle and Far East Studies, and at the Faculty of History, there is the Institute of Jewish Studies, dealing with history and culture of Jewish people. What's more, in 2018, Dr. Eva Bengzin from the Institute of Jewish Studies established Theodor Herzl and Ozia Shton's Center for Research on Modern Israeli and Polish-Jewish Relations. I would like now to express my appreciation to all the organizers who generously help us making this event happen. First of all, to Polish Institute in Tel Aviv and Director Mrs. Katarzyna Dzierżawska, to the Embassy of Republic of Poland, Israel, and His Excellencies Marek Magierowski, to Embassy of Israel in Poland, His Excellency Mr. Alexander Ben-Zvi. Thank you very, very much. We couldn't have done it without you. I would like to thank the ambassadors and panelists who are here today and will be sharing with us the perspective and experiences. I'm certain that this work and contribution in building the bilateral relation between Poland and Israel will broaden our knowledge today and help to better understand of our common history. I look forward for fruitful deliberations during the conference. Thank you for coming. Thank you for participation and have a good day for all of us. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Professor Sprawski, for joining us today. And now I would like to invite Mr. Zygmunt Stępiński, the director of the Museum of the History of Polish Jews, Polin, in Warsaw.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. The idea of establishing the Museum of the History of Polish Jews was born right after Poland regained its freedom in 1989. The idea was gained widespread support in society, including politicians from the opposition and ruling parties. Built in a historic location opposite to the monument of the hero of the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising, the Polin Museum tells the story of the 1000th year of the history of Jews in Poland. The most eminent scholars of Jewish history from many countries, especially Poland, the United States, and Israel, participated in the shaping of the core exhibition, thanks to which it was possible to create a narration reflecting different points of view and different sensitivities. The modern multimedia exhibition is designed to reach a diverse audience, from young children to experienced scholars. The opening of the museum building took place on April 19, 2013, on the 70th anniversary of the outbreak of the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising. We are honored by the presence of Kazik Simcha Rotem, who came from Israel for this ceremony. He was one of the last surviving fighters of the uprising, who in May 1943 led several dozen insurgents out of the ghettos through the sewers. One of the particularly spectacular forms of commemorating the ghetto uprising is the distribution of paper daffodils by the museum volunteers each year on April 19. Last year, 100 of them were distributed in the street of Warsaw, 30,000 in school in Israel, and 10,000 in a Jewish diaspora in the United States, as well as in a European Union parliament. The Polin Museum, apart from the core and temporary exhibition, offers a wide variety of educational and cultural programs. It is, in fact, a cultural center which holds meetings, conferences, performances related to the heritage of Polish Jews. Educational projects are directed both to the young people, but also to teachers, guides, cultural activists from all over the country. The museum is one of the most visited places in Warsaw. The visitors are both Poles and foreigners from all over the world. The largest group of foreign visitors come from Israel, and the second to them is the American Jewish diaspora in United States. Many educational projects are carried out jointly with Israeli institutions, such as the Ministry of Education, Yad Vashem Institute, and the University of Tel Aviv. The museum promotes youth exchange and meetings, conducts training for Israeli guides, and organizes study visits for Israeli school principals and teachers. The 1000th year of history of Polish Jews was one of the blank pages during the half century of communist rule. The museum not only fills this gap in a collective memory, but also supports numerous initiatives of local communities who want to discover and preserve the memory of their own Jewish local history. This is absolutely crucial for us. Thank you very much.